you know, this conference has been a very important conference because the people from all over the world, and they're discussing various problems. I am a Pakistani, and my interest is Afghanistan and Pakistan. The situation in Pakistan is not good at all, because the Taliban there and the other people who are, you know, militants, having a heyday. The problem is they are all Pakhtuns, and Pakhtuns are also living in Afghanistan and Pakistan, also in the Fatah. Now, what is happening is that the Pakhtuns are being beaten up by the Americans, the ISAF and the NATO, and on the same side, they are also being beaten up by the military. Actually, we don't have any strategy. We have to lay down a strategy, and in Pakistan, Pakistan should be too inclusive and should be the forefront of strategy, and in Afghanistan, it should be Afghan people who should be the forefront, not the outsiders. All the outsiders, whether NATO, whether it's ISAF, whether United States, they should be in complete support of what's happening here. The strategy should involve political dialogue. It should involve administrative measures. It should involve welfare measures and, where necessary, military action. But military action should be a very smart, small part of it, because military cannot win this war. These people are from this area. They owe this area. They are the fighter types. They will continue to fight. Their sons will continue to fight. Their grandsons will continue to fight. We don't want that to happen. We want peace in the area. Stability in Afghanistan is very important in Pakistan. So we must do something. In this conference, people have been talking about what to do. But the point is, who should be authorized to do it? If each one, the ISAF, NATO, United States, everybody is acting on its own, I think there will never be peace here. Every comprehensive plan should be made, a strategy should be made. There should be unity, Pakistan leading in Pakistan, Afghans leading in Afghanistan, and then all of them should support this. The more important fact is, we have to provide incentives for them. And we have to use the people of the area, who are not Taliban, who are proud people, but who are very good Muslims, who are very honorable people. They should be utilized. If they are utilized, they will know what to do. But they have been the last people to know what's happening. And people coming into our area, which is a sovereign state, firing at the people, having civilian casualties, girls and boys and old people, it will get us nowhere. We have to work out properly. And one important point is that unity of command is important. In Afghanistan, we should give the command to Karzai or some other Afghani who has everything under his control, and he can move in from there. Similarly, should be Pakistan. That is important. Now, whatever we always, the problem is the implementation. We make very good plans, we don't implement. There is no cortex, we are not implementing anything. There's too much of corruption. There are too many NGOs in Afghanistan. All these things have to be combined, they have to be implemented, and the most important thing is they have to be implemented with force, honesty and justice. Honesty and justice, I think, the most important thing in the world. The last word I'll say is, for Pakistan, I'm saying, the person who wears the shoe, he knows where it is pinching. The others don't know. Everybody is talking about Pakistan, blaming the Pakistan army, blaming the ISAF, which is not entirely true. I beg to differ. But we should get together, all of us should talk about it. All the important countries of the world, including Pakistan. That's, I think, very important.